parents are not doing a good job. They just have to be new people every Sunday.
Amen.
What are the company members of the church or not? You are doing your own part.
Amen. We want to keep this to
ourselves, right? Amen.
It's not so.
Brother Richard, you're welcome. Brother Joseph, you're welcome.
Amen.
These are our new members. Put your hands together for them.
Amen.
We're welcome in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
I hope you're still fasting.
Yes.
Even if you're going to pray by 2 p.m., it's okay. But when you fast, you have to pray.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense to fast and don't pray. Unless you want to lose a couple of pounds. It's okay.
We are here this morning.
When you lose a couple of pounds, it's okay. But if you want spiritual reward,
yes,
you have to add prayer to your fasting. Please try as much as you can to fast.
Amen.
You're not fasting for you. Amen. Me, I'm fasting for myself.
Amen.
This is what I'm telling about pastor or church. You're not fasting to grow the church. It's a part of your life.
Yes.
Jesus Christ said, this kind cannot go. Except with what?
Prayer.
Fast. So make it a point of duty to fast.
Amen.
As you're fasting, and you see what the Lord will do.
Amen.
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 Holy Spirit, I hand all back to you now. That you alone may speak for your people to hear. As you speak, O God, let understanding come. Let revelation come. Let an impartation, O God, of the power of God. Release, heal, and deliver through your word to your people. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, O God.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want to wrap up. You are the firstborn. Act like one. This is part three. The recap. Remember, we talked about how do you activate your experience upon your life. How do you activate your experience? We talked about that Christ came from the tribe of Judah. The Bible says that Jesus Christ is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. It is not in vain that Christ had to come from that tribe. I mean, there was the tribe of Reuben, there was the tribe of Simeon, there was the tribe of Levi. Why did Christ come through those three tribes? These were the first, second, and third born of Jacob. Yet, Christ had to come through the fourth born of Jacob. And that is the tribe of Judah. There's something peculiar, there's something spiritual about Judah. That name, Judah. And we talked about that, what Judah means. The Judah experiences. That as a child of God, you need to have these experiences. To experience the fullness of the blessings of God, you need to have these Judah experiences. But he said these experiences do not just come. They are not automatic. They have to be activated. Now, how do you activate Judah experience? We talk about praise. The name by itself means praise. We said let Judah go up first. The first thing you do in every circumstance, in every situation, before the battle, in the midst of the battle, after the battle, is to rise up and praise God. Shout hallelujah. Power in praise. Praise releases the presence of God. The Bible says God inhabits the praises of his people. Meaning, when you praise God, God descends into your circumstances. Oh, shout hallelujah. That's why we need to be powerful praisers of God. We talk about the right way to praise God. We say, first of all, people don't seem to understand how to praise God. First, you need to understand the attributes of God. Who is God to you? Let's begin to praise God by calling him by his name. The name you know about God and you believe about God is how God will manifest in your life. Or you don't get that. If you think that and you believe that God is a healer, believe me, he will be be a healer unto you. If you believe that God is a deliverer, He will deliver you. If you believe that God is a provider, He will provide, no matter the situation. So when you begin to call the attributes of God, you are letting God understand that, look, I know who you are, and I know what you can do. Shout hallelujah. And apart from praising God, you need to surrender unto Him. Let God know you are inadequate. Don't fight the battle yourself. Men of all fight the battles ourselves. Let God know that you cannot do it. The Bible says, not by might, not by power, but by what? My spirit.
Amen.
You know what? It's only the spirit of God that can do it.
Amen.
So you confess your inadequacies. And then you praise God in thanks, in merit. Praise God in thanksgiving. But now finally, praise God with your substance.
Amen.
I know people don't want to hear my substance. Shout
hallelujah.
Holy Ghost.
Fire.
Now listen to me. Now the next thing to do is to do what? To begin to behave like the firstborn that you are.
Amen.
You know what I said? You are the firstborn. Act like one.
Amen.
Many do not understand that they are the firstborn of God.
Amen.
Somebody asked me, how can I be the firstborn? We explained that being firstborn could be first in order of creation. It could be by divine appointment.
Yes.
It could be by preeminence of position.
Yes.
That you occupy.
Yes.
But we as children of God become firstborn by divine appointment.
Amen.
You know what? We don't merit it. It's not because we were born first. It's not because we merit it. It's because we become firstborn by divine appointment through the power of the Holy Spirit. Say, I'm the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn.
Oh, you don't even understand. You don't even mean it. Say, I'm the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn.
Touch somebody, say, I'm the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn.
I don't feel it. Say, I'm the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn of God. You married him. You are not a firstborn because you were born first. You are firstborn just like you now. You have not become firstborn of God because he was the firstborn of Jacob. He became firstborn by divine appointment. So you become firstborn by divine appointment. I am a firstborn. Now, why are you a firstborn? There's immense responsibility placed on the shoulder of the firstborn. I said here last week, the firstborn is the preserver and the defender of the common patrimony, common estate, common inheritance. Back home, our tradition places everybody on the firstborn. The parents look after the firstborn. To be able to defend the younger ones. To be able to rise up when there's need. To be able to be bold. To take bold decisions. The same way, when you are faithful to God, you are expected to rise up when it matters. You are expected to take bold decisions. You are expected to defend the heritage of God. You that experience cannot come upon you if you don't act as the firstborn that you are.
Amen. Yes.
Many children of God refuse to act as the firstborn that they are. Shout
hallelujah.
The question then becomes, how do you act? We said last week, you need to stand up to be counted.
Yes.
Say, stand up to be counted.
Stand up to be counted.
Say, stand up.
Stand up.
Stand up.
Stand up.
Tell someone, stand up to be counted.
Stand up to be counted.
Don't ever say, stand up to be counted.
Stand up to be counted.
Shout
hallelujah.
Hallelujah. How do we stand up? That's the question. I said last week, you stand up by having initiative. You stand up The Bible says she perceived that this is the man of God. Perception, discernment, knowledge of God like discernment. For God said, this woman have been childless for too long. I'm sure she'll be praying. But no children came. But the Bible says there's a time. The race is not for the swift. It may say time and chance happen to them all. Yeah. Meaning, there's always a particular time for that thing you're looking for to happen in your life. Amen. But you need to perceive it. You need to discern it. You start up by discerning the situation.
Yeah.
This woman, sorry, said, I perceive this is a man of God. Let's make room. So that he can eat. The end result of that was what? A child. Child, hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at Peter. Peter understood. Timing. Initiating. Discernment. He called there and died. He got nothing. But that particular woman came. Say, my time. My time has come.
My time has come.
Oh, you don't get that. Say, my time has come.
My time has come.
My time has come. You guys don't mean it. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
You've been toiling for too long. You've been toiling day and night. What are you waiting for? That time has come.
Yes.
When Jesus said, can I use a boat? He said, Christ. Was he really mad? Thank you. I told you that anyway. What difference does using my book make at this time? But it made the greatest difference in his life.
Amen.
Not only in his business, but in his spiritual life.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning, to wrap up, you are the firstborn, act like one. I want to bring something in. Brave it. You need to be brave. Taking bold decision. Have you stand up to be counted by being bold? The Bible says God has not given us the spirit of fear. God has not given the spirit of fear. Bold decisions. You by being brave in the face of adversity. Abba. Don't you know adversity will come? It's part and parcel of Christianity. Make no mistake about that. But how do you react when they come? If you want to experience yoga, the divine yoga, it calls for bold decisions. It calls for bravery. Numbers chapter 13. The Lord is calling Moses to send us spies. 12 spies were sent out. The God is bringing the land of Canaan. They went to the land of Canaan and they came back with a report. 10! Say 10.
10.
10 say, you know what? Moses, forget it. Look, this land that you talk about here devours its inhabitants. Look, listen to me, Moses. This land is well fortified. Look, the people that live in this land are giants, the descendants of Anna. Look, before them, we are like what? Grasshoppers. Don't even mess with this guy. I'm sure we religious people will say, they were faithless. Stop deceiving yourself. Because you will do the same thing.
Yes.
I probably will do the same thing. You know why? The report they brought was the truth. The report they brought was what they saw. to be able to possess that land. I mean, look at this way. God promised them this land. God wanted them to obtain that land because of this land. And at a point of breakthrough, see what is up. Judges. 45 sin. How about now? Look at your life. You have prayed and fasted, and you have done all that you're supposed to do. And the very moment that breakthrough is supposed to come, big obstacle. Won't you ask, which God is this? Are you going to be asking the same question? We are all like those 10 spies.
Yes.
All of us here, we are like the 10 spies. Yes, you have labored all the promises of God, all the miracles you have heard, all the word of God that you have read. You have tried to do the will of God. But at the time it matters most, when you're going to receive that phone call or that breakthrough or that job, what do you hear? We are sorry to inform you. Papa. Sorry to inform. God, where are you? Are you no more God? Do you not promise me? Did I not walk with you? Why? The best part. Only reported what they saw. Mm-hmm. But let me, all of us here are the best spies. Mm-hmm. Don't let anybody to preach the Bible to you and say, some pastor will say, they were so friendless. That pastor will be even worse than that.
Amen.
Because these people saw the reality on the ground.
Yes, the fact.
They were maybe disappointed. Mm-hmm. God, how come? You promised us all this while. You push us through the wilderness and we suffer like this. And you say there's a land that came for us. And this very land, we can't even inhabit it. What kind of God are you? That is exactly the mindset. All of us. So don't try to judge them. Some minister, when they preach so religiously. Oh, they were so weak-minded. Oh, they were so fearful. Oh, they had no faith. Oh, please. Let's say the real thing the way it is. I will be disappointed with you. I will be angry with you. My people lost their lives in the wilderness because of this land. And the God is telling me, I will give you the land. And when I'm about to enter, at the point of entry, I can't enter. The land is sealed. And the spirit should be so happy. I begin to thank God and that. No. The 10th part reported what they saw. They saw what the situation wanted to see. They saw with their physical eyes, the same way we see our situation. We might have called prophets and spiritualists from Africa. They might have been prophesying. Some of them praying, doing some assignments. And then some of them might tell you, look, you will never get married. Since that what I see is too powerful. You'll not get that job. The power I find in you, brother, is too strong. Let's do some rituals and sacrifices. These things are real. Are they lying?
No.
It might be true. Why? Because that is what they see. That is the circumstance. That is what their eyes will see. Their physical eyes will see. So they might retain the truth. But there's a different dimension to this story. Somebody that wants to activate the Udoh experience is a brave person.
Amen.
A brave person takes bold steps.
Amen.
bold. If what you are going through is easy. A step cannot be what? Cannot be bold. If what you are looking for comes easy. Shout hallelujah. Boldness comes with seeing through the eyes of God.
Yes.
Oh, you don't get that. Oh, you don't get that. God did not say there will be no obstacles. He didn't say there will be no opposition. If you remember, God did not tell the children of Israel, the land they are looking for will come easily. Mm-hmm. But he told them what? I will be with you.
Yes.
In other words, in the midst of opposition, I'll be with you.
Yes.
In the midst of judgment, I'll be with you.
Amen.
In the midst of fortified city, I'll be with you.
Amen.
Even me, you will see through the eyes of God. Through the eyes of God, impossibilities become possible.
Amen.
Through the eyes of God, fortified city, the city, the world begin to crumble.
Yes.
Through the eyes of God, the judges scream and become like ants.
Amen.
No wonder there were two people, two out of the 12. They saw the same thing that the 10 saw. The report was correct. But what made a difference? They refused to see through the eyes of man.
Yes.
They took bold steps. And what did they say? They said, wait a minute. And so they looked back and said, what about Jagat, 45 city? Well, if God promised me this land, we will get it.
Yes.
That is boldness. That is seeing through the eyes of God. If God has spoken, he is also faithful to do it.
Yes.
If he has spoken to you, he is never going to fulfill it.
Amen.
The God that led us to the wilderness.
Amen.
The God that divided the Red Sea. The God that rained down manna from heaven.
Yes.
Oh, is that same God that will subdue the dragon?
Is
that same God that will break down the walls? Is that same God that will give us the land?
Amen.
We will do it. We will get the land. You know Moses. We are going to get the land. That is the man with boldness. That is the man that refused to operate in the spirit of fear and doubt. That is the man that wants to release you that experience of calling his life.
Yes.
What happened? By the way, do you know that Kenneth came from the tribe of Judah? Shout
hallelujah.
You know they selected by tribe.
Yes.
One person. This same Kenneth, you know what? Came from the tribe of Judah. No wonder.
Amen.
No wonder. He understood the place of the firstborn.
Mm-hmm.
He understood that he is the firstborn. He must rise up and take some bold decisions in the face of opposition, in the face of difficulties. He rose up, being a firstborn that he was, to take some bold decisions and tell the people, look, don't wonder, sir, we'll take that land. I like that boasting. There's some say that boasting in the Lord. If you want both, let your boast be your God. Boast of what God can do. Boast of who God is.
Yes.
Boast. Because you know him. Caleb boasted. We'll tell the lie. Those people are nothing before us. Why? They saw through the eyes of God.
Amen.
The God of impossible. eyes of God.
Yes.
Other eyes will fail you. In fact, somebody listening that we call prophecy. Some people operate under the spirit of spiritual, even though they wear jacket and tie and speak polished English. Familiar spirit is speaking through them. And they come to prophecy like, hey, you're gonna die. You will not marry. They say, you're not gonna jump. It's a powerful wish in your village. This thing might be true. No doubt about it. But if you do not see through the eyes of God, you fall victim to their prediction. You can never marry if you don't see through the eyes of God. You will not get that job if you don't see through the eyes of God. The things you are looking for, you will not get them if you don't see through the eyes of God. If the blood is going to be bent on the test five, then you never have gotten Canaan. Do you understand me?
Yes.
They have never gotten Canaan. Because it was impossible to get that land. Mm-hmm. But the true people activated that experience upon their life.
Amen.
And they told the people, we will get it.
Amen.
Tell somebody, I will get it.
I will get it.
But you understand? Tell somebody, I will get it.
I will get it.
Yes, yes, I will get it.
I will get it.
I will get my breakthrough.
I will get my
deliverance.
I'll get my healing.
I'll get my job.
I'll get my
papers.
I'll get my
ministry.
Shout
hallelujah.
I will get it.
I must make it. It is a must. Not I may, I will.
I must. You need to come to that conviction
in your spirit.
It's not you.
The moment you have that conviction, the powers of God begin to line up behind you.
What do I say?
They begin to line up behind you. And things that were impossible started becoming possible. Because it is not you. It is the power of the Spirit of the living God. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Look at somebody before we wrap up. Nehemiah. We look at Nehemiah, chapter 1, 2, 3, and 4. The walls of Jerusalem were all broken down. In Babylon, they were in captivity. But only Nehemiah, when the report came, only Nehemiah. Of all those people there, Nehemiah was the person that said, you know what? Oh my God, he wept. He said, the wall, the glory of Jerusalem is being put under reproach. I must do something. The interesting thing is this. The Bible says Nehemiah waited for the right time. Say time.
Time.
He still brings us to time.
Time.
He had the ears of the king. When they were bringing gift to the king, Nehemiah took the gift himself. It wasn't his gift. The people that were bringing, Nehemiah took himself and took it to the king. The king, and he was angry, he frowned his face. He said, hey, wait a minute, Nehemiah, you don't look good. I know it's not food, we have gift, you are satisfied, but should be from your heart. He said, my king, my city is the room, and we're under reproach. Permit me to go and rebuild the city. The king said, how long are you going to go? Give them a say, oh. He said, King, before you release me, send me some help, armed people. Give letters to all the surrounding king so that they will grant me safe passage. He said, it is done.
Bam!
He waited for the right time. He perceived the time that the king was giving him.
Amen.
And he took the poster to rebuild the broken walls of Jerusalem. I'm sure you think it was an easy job. No, there were people that rose up. All the Sambalas of this world, the Tobias of this world, all of them rose up and reproached this man of God.
Amen.
He took a poster. How many will rise up in the face of opposition?
Amen.
When it doesn't look like it, when it's not easy. How many You must be bold.
Amen.
Bravery.
Amen.
In the midst of opposition. In the midst of what people are saying about you.
Yes.
These are some of the ways you can activate you that experience upon you.
Amen.
What you are going through will come only when you understand.
Yes.
The timing, the opportunity, the steps that you need to take. To understand, it is not about you. Let God be God.
Amen.
Shout out to me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you can pray to God now, ask God to give you, to take away the spirit of fear from your life. Ask God, pray. This is your prayer. Take away the spirit of fear, O God, from my life. Fear is what keeps you where you are. Fear is what makes you to lose faith. Fear is what makes you to make mistakes. Fear is what makes you not to reap your rehabilitation. The enemy puts you in captivity because of fear. Ask God. By your power, O God, take away the spirit of fear from me. By your power, O God, take away the spirit of fear from me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, pray. Pray, pray. Pray. Tell the Lord, take away the spirit of fear from me. From my children, from my husband, from my wife. Take away, oh God, the spirit of fear. From Gilgal Christian Center, from members of this church, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Say, spirit of fear. In the mighty name of Jesus. I bind you.
I bind you.
I bind you.
In
the name of Jesus.
Bind
the spirit of fear. Bind. Bind that spirit. New spirit of fear. In this church. In our lives. I take authority over you. In the name of Jesus. I bind you. I bind you. I bind you. And I cast you out of our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Say, I receive the spirit of boldness now. I receive the spirit of boldness now. Begin to receive it, receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. The spirit of boldness. Come upon us now. Spirit of boldness. Hey! Mother of a sheep come about. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I release the spirit of holiness, the spirit of sound mind, the spirit of wisdom upon your life. Receive the spirit of discernment to discern the right time and opportunity. To discern the right course of action in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By the boldness of God upon your life, begin to do exploit, begin to go beyond the ordinary to the extraordinary in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, O God. Because we know it's not about God, but it's all about you. Have your way, speak of living God. Let the impossibility, what the enemy thinks is impossibility, what we even think is impossibility, to become possible by your power. Let the way when it seems to be going, where all doors have been shut, open them, oh God. Let the walls of Jericho crumble before us. Capture the heart and the minds of people. Connect us, oh God, to the right opportunity.
In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, oh God, for being here. We worship and we bless the Holy Spirit. As we go this week, go with us. We step into this week with power. We step into this week with testimony. We step into this week with breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. Because the church of God is marching on. No king of hell will prevail against this church. Bind us together, oh God, with the law. You are divine law that no power can break. I bind the spirit of Christ, commotion, ill feelings. I bind those spirits and I cast them out of members of this church. I release the spirit of love, commitment, loyalty, what I call dedication, selfless service upon the members of this church. Together we'll make progress. Together we'll end this year strong. We'll even begin next year stronger. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, O God. In Jesus' name we are praying.